So we looked at the longitudinal static stability for a standard configuration of aircraft like this one. And today we will discuss the standard periodic movements, oscillations, both periodic and aperiodic actually, which such a standard configuration has. And maybe you can recognize some of them in real flight later. These are the ones that we will discuss. Two longitudinal ones, the fugoid and the short period, and laterally the Dutch roll, aperiodic roll, and the spiral. What are they? Well, let's start with the fugoid. The fugoid is a very slow maneuver which goes something like this. It goes nose up, nose down. And if we look at it more carefully, we have an animation here. Let's go full screen and then look at the animation. What it does is basically exchanges kinetic and potential energy. So the altitude energy and the energy due to speed. So you have less altitude and higher speeds in the lower part, and then it decreases again. And this can continue for quite a while. It's not damped very much. And the period is about 30 seconds, so that's really noticeable. And one way you can notice it is as a passenger to look at when the sun shines through your window, to look at the border of the shadow of your front seat, because you can use this as an attitude indicator, and you can really see this movement. Some airliners have really experiences worse than others, and try if you can see this the next time that you're in the passenger seat of an airliner. There's also a faster one. A short period has basically the same kind of movement, so it also goes up and down, but it dampens out very quickly. It's hardly periodic. In fact, it dampens so fast that you will have trouble noticing more than one period. It has a very short period. We can see it here. Basically the same movement, but then very quickly damped. And this is a period is 2 to 5 seconds. And like I said, hard to notice because of the high damping. Well, laterally, there are different movements. And one that is a sort of you could regard it as the fugoid for asymmetrical movements, is the Dutch roll, or which is basically like a swing or a pendulum, where the aircraft does something like this. And it does it very gently, not very well damped. We have a picture of it here. It really large excitations and not very well damped. Other typically asymmetrical movements of standard configurations are the spiral. And this, of course, means that when the aircraft goes into a spiral, that there's more lift required. So the pilot pulls, or the aircraft reacts with a higher angle of attack, but the aircraft pulls. And if you generate more lift, you will create more centrifugal motion, and you might pull it into the spiral. So this makes it much worse, and this spiral movement downwards gets worse and is not damped. You really have to first turn back and then pull to get out of the spiral. And the final one is the aperiodic roll, and that's a short excitation in roll movement, which is automatically corrected. It doesn't have a period, it's very quickly damped, and has to is a result of the vertical tail being on top of the fuselage. So those are 5 typical motions that every standard configuration aircraft, so wing first and the tail aft, and the vertical tail, one vertical tail on top, that experiences these oscillations.